So class, what we are talking about today is a shell sort. It is again a divide and conquer approach. I have an array, supposedly any array is existing. What am I trying to do? I'm trying to do insertion sorting in groups of shells. So what I do basically within an array is I break the array, not by first half, second half, not like this. What I do in shell sorting is initially I will break the array in, you can see it is max by 2. So whatever is my size of the array, supposedly n is my size of the array. So I'm breaking the array in n by 2 floor. So if you are seeing that there are 5 elements, so 5 by 2 floor value will be, this is 2.5, so floor value will be 2. So shell size, this is only telling me the shell size. What do you mean by shell size? We'll just understand. So 2 is what we have found. Now what we do, these are the elements. Shell size is 2. How do we perform shell sort is, we are comparing the elements which are at a gap of this particular shell size. In case I am doing the sorting in ascending order, if the first element is greater than the element with which this is compared, I will swap. That's it. So this is 5, my first element. My shell size is 2. So after 2 elements, what is the element which is coming? Since the shell size is 2, after 2 elements, 8 is there. So I compare 5 with 8. Since 5 is not greater, it remains there only. Then I do the same thing in the shell size. I hope I am making myself clear. I compare 2 with 10. Since again, they will remain as it is, then I will again compare. Now here they all are remaining in the same at this shell size and nothing will happen. Next, I will again try to find out, same thing is happening here. If you see what is happening, I am calculating the shell size while the shell size is greater than 0. What am I doing? I am running a loop from the, see, there are 2 elements to be compared. So this is my I, which is at the beginning of the loop, and this is my J, which is at the shell, just size ka shell hai. Till J is less than the max element, then I am running in a loop, I is J minus S, that is J minus shell size will be beginning with 0 in our case, obviously. I has to be greater than 0 and I am decreasing now. I is I minus, I am just doing the shell size here and nothing is going on. So in case I am just going to compare the elements, this is I plus S. If A of I is greater than A of I plus S, swap the elements. Else break from the inner loop, go to the outer loop. There are 2 loops, actually there are 3 loops if you can see. So in case I have first element to be greater than the next, I am doing swapping in ascending order. Then swap the elements, otherwise you will break. Recalculate the shell size to be shell size by 2 again. It is again the floor value. So after first, this array remains addresses. By chance, I have taken an example. Let me take an example where swapping is there. And let me make you understand what is happening. So supposedly, I am having an
excuse me, ma'am.
Haan, beta.
Ma'am, this S is equal to S by 2 is a part of the upper loop, right?
S is equal to S by 2 is a part of the while loop ka hai. While loop ka variable hai na S. While loop mein variable should be changed.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Theek hai?
Yes, ma'am.
I will rewrite it so that you all understand. This else belongs here. And this else mein I'm having break. And this...
And both the for loops get over after else.
Both the for loop get over after else. And this I'm changing the S. Now I hope it
okay, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Let me take another example in which we are facing some changes so that I am putting them in the order so that some changes exist. Supposedly, this is my array. Supposedly now. This array is having 6 elements. So 6 elements are there. So max is 6. Max by 2.
Dono for loop ke baad ki hai.
3. We'll just see the condition. You don't worry. Dono for loop ke baad ki hai. I'll make you understand what is happening. डोंट वरी, यू जस्ट लुक एट हेयर फर्स्ट, फॉरगेट दिस, ठीक है? आप इससे समझ लो, अभी आई विल मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड. After this, what is happening is now my size becomes 3. So my shell size is 3. In what is happening in 3, if you go by the loop, you check shell size greater than 0. Yes. Now J becomes equal to the shell, which is 3 in this case. So if this is beginning with 0, 1, 2, so this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So J becomes 3. Correct? Right? J becomes this index. I is J minus S, I becomes this index. Since the shell size is 3, I am going to compare the elements at a gap of 3. I hope I am making sense. So in the first iteration of the inner loop, ab hum yahan pe aa rahe hain, theek hai? I am comparing A of I with A of I plus S. That is the shell size that I am getting. Now 10 greater than 4 is true. I will swap the elements. So the new array here will become 4, 2, 8, 10, 6, and 7. Fine? Yes, no?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Again, I will go. What I will do is, I will now increment the value. Now here when I am going to do I is I minus S, the condition will become false. I will go to the upper loop automatically. So I go to the upper loop. What is having? J plus plus. So J becomes this. I again go to the inner loop, I becomes this. J becomes 4, 3 plus 1 is 4, and I becomes J minus S, it becomes 1. Am I clear? I again compare 2 with 6. 2 is less than 6, condition is true. I will break from this particular loop. I again go above. I again increment J. Now J becomes 5. Okay? Are you all understanding what I am doing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, J becomes 5. J less than 6 is again true. I becomes 2. I compare 8 with 7. When I am comparing 8 with 7, 8... Now, this condition 8 greater than 7 is true. I will again swap the elements. These two are swapped. So, the new array becomes 4, 2, 7, 10, 6 and 8. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, when I am again going, I is I minus S, I is 2 here, 2 minus 3 is again 0, so I will not be comparing any more elements here. I go to the outer loop, J plus plus, J becomes 6, 6 less than 6 is false, the condition becomes false. I come out of these two loops. This is my first pass of shell sort. After the first pass of shell sort, this is the array that I am having. Now I will decrease the shell size by half. I will again decrease the shell size. So the shell size decreases. I'm rubbing the initial loop here, initial array. So after the first pass, this is the array I'm having, and the shell size, initially shell size is 3 now. Now it becomes 3 by 2, which becomes 1.5. Floor value I'm taking, so it becomes 1. Since it is going to take the integer value automatically, so I don't have to make any changes here. It becomes 1. Now the shell size is only of 1. So I'm going to compare the elements immediately. So what is happening now? Again, come to the inner loop. Shell size is still greater than 0. 1 is greater than 0 is again true. J is equal to S. Now, if I am redrawing the array here, the array after the first pass that I'm having, it is having the elements in this manner. So J becomes S. So J becomes 1. This is my J initially here. I becomes J minus S, it becomes 0. I compare A of I greater than A of I plus S. No. Oh, yes. 4 is greater than 2. They are swapped. 4 greater than 2 is true. I will be swapping the elements. So what happens here? The new array becomes 2, 4, 7, 10, 6 and 8. Now again, in this array, I will do I is I minus S. I is 0 minus 1. It is not greater than equal to 0. I come out of the inner loop. I go to the outer loop. I increment the value of J. It becomes 2. The value of J becomes 2. After the value of J becomes 2, I again go to the inner loop. I becomes J minus 1. So I becomes 1. I will again compare 2 greater than 7 is false. I will break from the inner loop. I will go to the outer loop. I increment the value of j. It becomes 3. J is still less than max. Come to the inner loop again. I is 2. Compare 7 and 10. Again, 7 is not greater than 10. Break from this loop. Come to the outer loop. Increment the value of j to be 4. Recalculate the value of I to be j minus 1. It becomes 3. Compare 10 and 6. Yes, 10 is greater than 6. So swap the two values here. So I am swapping these two values so that the new array will here become this particular 2, 4, 7, 6, 10 and 8. So 6 and 10 have been swapped. After this, now I's new value is I minus S. Please understand. So I's new value is this. I again check. Now I becomes 2. 2 is greater than 0 is true. I again check. 7 and now what? Understand that the comparison is I and I plus S. Again, jab bhi comparison hoga, shell size ke beech mein hi hoga. So I am comparing these two elements now. So whether these two elements not in this array, I am comparing 7 and 6. Because what I have to do is I have to insert 6 in its correct position. This is a part of insertion sorting that happens in shell sizes. So what am I doing? 7 greater than 6 is still true. I will swap the two values. Abhi inner loop mein chal rahe hain. So what happens? 2, 4, 6, 7, 10, 8. Now I is currently at 2 value. I again go in this loop. I is I minus S. I becomes 1. I again compare 4 and 6. 4 is not greater than 6. I will break from the inner loop. I go to the outer loop. I increment the value of j. J becomes 5. Now new I becomes 4. Now I and j are compared. 10 is greater than 8 is true. I will swap the two values. So the new array will become 2, 4, 7, 8 and 10. Now within this, I will decrement the value of I. And I will again compare 7 and 8. Since 8 is not 7 is not greater than 8, I will break from the loop. Then I again increment the value of j. It goes equal to max. I will come out from the outer loop also. Then I will again decrement the shell size by 2. So shell size, new shell size will be 1 by 2, which becomes 0. So condition of my while loop is greater than 0 becomes false. I come out of all the loops and I have my sorted array using the shell sort. Am I making myself clear to all? Should I take another example and explain?
Ma'am, can you please just repeat one step after we broke from 7, after comparing 7 and 8, we broke and then what we did?
After comparing 7 and 8 here.
Yes, ma'am.
After comparing 7 and 8, when we compare 7 and 8, I was decremented. We were in the inner loop. So we were comparing 7 and 8. 7 is not greater than 8. It is less than 8. If condition becomes false, so we go to else, we break from the inner loop. We go to the outer loop. Is it
yes, clear? Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Clear to all, or should I take another example? I have no issues in explaining this once again. We are just doing comparisons in shell size. Should I erase this?
Yes, ma'am.
I hope all have noted. Let me take just one another example to make you understand what is happening. Now you understand how the code was running. That I believe nobody has any doubt in. Let me just take a similar example and make you understand one, two passes of the same so that you understand what is happening here. Supposedly, this is my array. I hope it is visible to all. And these are the indexes of the array. So there are 7 elements in the array. So if I calculate shell size, it is 7 by 2. Initially, it becomes 3. Floor value of 3.5 is 3. So what is happening is, I am creating technically two parts or two shells. And what will happen? 11 will be, this is one part, this is second part, and I will be comparing every element of the two parts. And I will be doing swapping. Ab jo swapping hogi, the only thing which happens later on is insertion sort ki jagah swap karne pe, uski sahi position pe insert karna hai. That is all I am doing. So initially what will happen, this element is compared with the element at third position. So if my pass is 3 hai, so what is happening? I compare these two. Obviously, 11 is greater than 9. I will be swapping these two. This becomes my new array. After comparing these two, I will compare these two also. Because I was initially 1, so usse less than I pe koi fayda nahi hoga na, shell size decrease karke. I will compare these two. Again, 5 is greater than 4. I will be swapping the values. I will again compare 8 and 2 here. After comparing 8 and 2, I will be realizing that again I need to swap the two. So I will again be swapping the two values. Again, what am I doing is I will compare 11 with 1. Again, swapping needs to be performed. So I will again be swapping the two elements. And I will again be comparing 5 with 0. Kab tak jana hai? Jab tak second loop ka element khatam na ho jaye. J, jab tak max se chota hai, jab tak we are continuing this. Again, I will be swapping. So the array after the first part pass of my shell sort is this. After the first pass, the final array after shell sort ke pehle pass ke baad jo hume mil raha hai, wo ye mil raha hai. Jisme humne kaun se size ke shell pe sorting kari hai? We have done sorting on the shell size of 3. We have not sorted the array. We have just taken a shell size or hame compare karke exchange kara. That is all we have done. Is this clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So after this, kya ho raha hai? After I have got the array of the initial pass, now my shell size will reduce to half. Now the shell size would reduce to half. So initially shell size was 3. Now shell size become 3/2, which becomes 1 in my case now. The shell size is now 1. Now I will compare every two elements. Now, oh sorry, it's not visible. When I'm comparing every two elements, what is happening that I have to realize is ki jab insertion hogi, jab swapping hogi, to previous elements se check karna bhi zaruri hai. To shell sort runs on the previous elements also. What is happening here, we'll understand. Kyunki hume sahi position pe insertion karni hai. It is nothing but insertion sorting within shell sizes. Now, shell size is 1. I will again re-begin the values of I and J initially. Now, if these are the positions of the elements, I will again be running J is 4, 9 and 4 will be compared initially. Since 9 is greater than 4, I will need to swap the two values. So it becomes 4, 9, 2, 1, 0, 8, 11 and 5. I will again be, now I less than, when I will be doing 0 se minus karke, I greater than equal to 0 will not be there. So I will not be checking it. There is no other element before 4. I will check for 9 and 2 now. J ki value increment ho gayi hai. When I am checking these two, I need to again swap the elements. So the new array becomes 1, 0, 8, 11 and 5. Now within the same swapping, abhi ye wali swapping finish nahi hui hai. Kyun nahi hui hai? Because the element that I have swapped might not be inserted in the correct position of the shell size. So I have to check. So I am again checking in the same shell size, 4 and 2. 4 is again greater than 2. It needs to be swapped again. Within the same shell size, I need to do the swapping again. So now I ka inner loop ab yahan pe khatam hua hai. Now J is incremented here. Now J becomes this. So I will again be comparing. So what is happening is when I am comparing these two, one ki jo insertion hai, wo uski correct position pe hogi within the shell size. Again, same thing will repeat. Haan, beta.
Ma'am, aapne pehle wale pass mein ye cheez ki nahi thi ki J I minus S wale ko to check hi nahi kiya tha.
Kara beta, kara. Yahan pe kara, dekho. फिर से देखो.
नहीं मैम, फर्स्ट पास में नहीं किया था.
फर्स्ट पास में क्यों नहीं किया था? बिकॉज शेल साइज 3 था. जब आई हम रन कर रहे हैं, आई रन कर रहा है, पहले 0 था, फिर आई वन हुआ, फिर आई टू हुआ, जब आप इनमें से माइनस थ्री करोगे तो वैल्यू लेस देन जीरो आएगी ना, तो हमें चेक नहीं करना पड़ेगा, इसलिए नहीं किया था।
बाद वाले केसेस में
करना चाहिए था। I must have missed it out. The algorithm will not miss out.
Change हो रहा है इससे, मतलब हमारा miss हो गया है।
तो it should have been done again. Because the algorithm would run in the same manner. It will not. In case, I hope all of you are understanding this clearly. I की value in case I have missed out, that will run in the correct manner. In case I have missed it out somewhere. I don't know the initial array right now. In case I've missed it out, if I was comparing 3 with 6 and then I was changing, then also 3 with 0 should have been compared again. Am I clear in that?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in the exam, while showing an example, can we just show the first pass?
In the exam, you need to show one pass in complete for sorting techniques, and then you can give the final answer as a sorted answer only. So you need
yes,
to show
yes,
one pass in complete. Anybody has any doubt in this? Or should I take another example? Some reply, please.
Ma'am, it's clear.
Thank you so much. Only one answer. Baki sab, I have no idea, sun bhi rahe hai ya nahi. So let's see the complexity now. So if I'm going to calculate the complexity of the shell sorting, what becomes the complexity here? Can you all, if you recall...
Ma'am, I was speaking, but I didn't realize that my mic was on mute.
Go ahead.
Ma'am, nothing, ma'am.
If you recall, I have three loops. I have a while, I have a for, I have another for. While is running for shell size, for is running for j, which is running from jm to max, and I have a loop running for I. Now, I is changing according to the shell size from I to 0, and this is changing according to the shell size. Step size is shell size. So, ये तीन लूप थे ना हमारे इनिशियल, तो इन तीन लूप की कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, दे हैव टू बी मल्टीप्लाइड, यस और नो?
यस
यस मैम,
दिस इज हाउ वी कैलकुलेट द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ एनी एल्गोरिथम. सो व्हाइल एस ग्रेटर देन जीरो, हाउ मच टाइम इज दिस लूप गोइंग टू टेक? एस इज चेंजिंग बाय स्टेप्स ऑफ हाफ, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड. So if I'm changing log S by half every time, how much time will the while loop take?
Log
order of n cube, order of
base
n
3 n.
by 2. Order of log n while will take, ye theek hai? While will run how many times? Log n times. Ye theek ho gaya? Agar shell size 8 hai, toh 8, 4, 2, 1 ke liye run karega. Ye samajh aa raha hai na? अगर तो 7, 3, 1 के लिए रन करेगा. दिस इज क्लियर? सो व्हाइल लूप्स रन हाउ मेनी टाइम्स? इट इज रनिंग लॉग एन टाइम्स. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू ऑल. नाउ हाउ मेनी टाइम्स इज द फॉर लूप रनिंग, द आउटर फॉर लूप फ्रॉम जे टू मैक्स? जे इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम शेल साइज, सो मैक्सिमम टाइम इट इज गोइंग टू टेक इज एन.
यस मैम.
Whatever be the shell size, whatever be the value, j is going to be incremented 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 every time. So it is going to take n repetitions.
Yes, ma'am.
And the inner for loop, here the value of I is changing. I is equal to I minus s. Is it changing like this?
Yes, ma'am.
So how much time is this for loop going to take? Now,
ma'am, it's the...
It is?
Ma'am, I minus S.
Say, agar hum calculation karna chahein, to when the S size is greater, to loop chalega hi nahi bahut baar, and when S size is small, the loop will run till N. So if I'm going to calculate all, it also comes out to be of the order log N. Agar aap tree bana ke same calculation karoge, to initially 0 times it is running, and later on it is running till all the times. But shell size still remains the same, right? इफ कंडीशन को हम काउंट नहीं करते वाइल टेकिंग द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी. सो दिस ऑल्सो गोइंग टू रन फॉर ऑफ द ऑर्डर लॉग एन टाइम इन एवरेज केस. So if I am calculating the complexity, I have to multiply because these are nested loops.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So if I am multiplying, this becomes n log square n. The complexity of my shell sort becomes n log square n. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
This is the worst case complexity. If I almost sorted elements are there and in this loop I will never be having an element jisme ki a of I wo condition agar if condition bar bar false hogi to this loop would never run again.
Yes ma'am.
This loop will run only for one best case mein this loop will run only for one time.
Yes ma'am, it will break.
So the best case complexity of shell sort is n log n.
N log n.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
And the worst case complexity for shell sort is n log square n.
And ma'am, average case then?
Average case is also log square n only.
Okay, ma'am.
Best case is n log square n. Best case is n log n. When the inner for loop is running only for one time every time. It is not undergoing okay, any ma'am. Repetitions. Is the complexity clear of shell sort to all?
Ma'am, can you explain the